Welcome everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. So today we shall study about molecular mass and concept of mole from class 9 and lesson is measurement of matter. So student, we have completed already few videos on this lesson, so you can go and check out my playlist to understand complete lesson in better way. All right, so let's study our today's concept. Okay, so let's study first about chemical symbols of elements. So student, Dalton used certain sign to represent elements. Okay, and here is a chart of some element which Daltons have discovered. Okay, so here you can observe elements are given and Dalton symbols are given in next column. So first is for hydrogen, he used this symbol. For carbon, black circle. For oxygen, blank circle. And for phosphorus, sulfur, platinum, iron, copper, silver, gold, lead and mercury. So these are the various symbols which Dalton used to represent an element. Okay, and today we use the symbols determined by IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. But today we are not using the Dalton symbol, just we are using the symbol which have been determined by IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. All right, so these are official names and symbols and are used all over the world. So we are using just these symbols. Okay, all right, so the current method of choosing chemical symbol is based on the method invented by Berzelius. That means this is a scientist who discovered the John Jacob Berzelius. This scientist discovered the chemical symbol for certain elements. Okay, and according to this method, the symbol of an element is either the first letter or the first and second another specific letter in its name. That means if I will explain you an example, and out of the two letters, the first is written as capital letter and the second is small letter. Now let us understand by this table. So here chemical symbols of different element are given. First is name symbol. Okay, so if you will observe and if you will notice here, for carbon the letter is C. Okay, the symbol for carbon according to the John Jacob Berzelius is C. Okay, and C, this is a first letter and C is written in the capital letter. All right, now if we will observe here, aluminium, bromine, calcium, chromium, etc. Okay, so the symbol for aluminium is Al. Okay, so first letter is written in capital and next letter is written in small letter. Like here for bromine, B is first alphabet from bromine and it is written in capital, and R is the second letter from bromine. Okay, bromine, B, R. So first is B, next is R. So this is a chemical symbol according to John Jacob Berzelius. Okay, all right, so our next topic is molecules of elements and compound. So atom of some elements such as helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon and oganesson, these are the some of the element, and these elements have the independent existence. It means that these elements are in monoatomic molecular state. That means they will not combine with another atom, they remain in monoatomic, that means only single atomic molecular state. Like we know in H2O water molecule, what is there here? H2 is there, O is there. That means these are the polyatomic molecular state. It means many atoms of different element are combined together to form a water molecule. Okay, but here these helium, neon, argon, krypton, these are exist in a monoatomic molecular state. Okay, so here sometimes two or more atoms of an element combine to form molecules of that element. Okay, and such elements are in a polyatomic molecular state. That means when two or more atoms of an different element combine to form molecules, so this is called as a polyatomic molecular state. But only when one elements are exist in only single molecular state, it is called as a monoatomic. And when two atoms are present in two atoms of element, two atoms of element combined together to form a molecule, it is called as a diatomic. Okay, so remember the difference between mono, di and polyatomic molecular state. All right, so here for example, the elements oxygen, nitrogen are in diatomic molecular state as O2, N2 and H2. So these are the two atoms of same elements are combined together to form a molecule. Okay, when atoms of different elements combine with each other, the molecules of compounds are formed, and in other words, compound are formed by chemical attraction between different elements. So like water molecule is there, carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide. Okay, so these are the atoms of different element combined to form a molecules or compounds, okay, by means of a chemical combination. Alright, so our next, so here are the monoatomic and diatomic molecule examples are given, like monoatomic helium. Just we have studied in our previous slide. Okay, so the example of diatomic molecule is H2. That means two atoms of hydrogen are combined to form hydrogen molecule. Okay, that is H2 nitrogen, F2 fluorine, O2 oxygen, I2 iodine, Cl2 chlorine and Br2 it is for bromine. And our next topic is molecular mass and the concept of mole. Now let's see what is it. Okay, so first is a molecular mass. So the molecular mass of a substance is the sum of atomic masses of all the atoms in a single molecule of that substance. Okay, that means like a water molecule is there. So in water molecules, it is a sum of all the hydrogen and oxygen atoms. This is called as a molecular mass. Alright, and the molecular mass is expressed in the unit Dalton U, and the value for 1 U or 1 Dalton is equals to 1.66053904 into 10⁻²⁷ kg. Now, here, how to deduce the molecular mass of water molecule? Let's understand this. So here one table is given in your textbook, page number 50. So here the molecule is given, water molecule, and the constituent of elements, that is constituent of element is here hydrogen and oxygen is there. Okay, so hydrogen and oxygen, so atomic mass of hydrogen is 1, this is fixed. Okay, and atomic mass of, what is atomic mass? This is the sum of proton and neutron. So in hydrogen only it is 1, and oxygen, proton and neutron number is 8 plus 8, that means 8 proton, 8 neutron, so it is total 16. Alright, and number of atoms in the molecule is 2, and atomic mass will be 1 multiplied by 2. Why here 2? Because 2 hydrogen atoms are there. Okay, so it 2 hydrogen atoms are there, so it is 2. H2 is there, na? So 1 multiplied by 2. Atomic mass U multiply by number of atoms, so your number of atoms are 2. Okay, and in oxygen only 1 atom is there, so that's why 16 multiplied by 1. And mass of the constituent U must, it is 2 and 16. Now here molecular mass formula is there. So molecular mass is equals to sum of constituent atomic masses, that means all the summation of all the constituent atom atomic mass. Okay, so molecular mass of water will be equal to sum of constituent. Okay, so here 2 atoms are there, na? Hydrogen atom, and next is oxygen. So here atomic mass of hydrogen, that is H, multiplied by 2. Why? Because 2 atoms are there, and here atomic mass of oxygen multiplied by 1, because only 1 atom is there. Alright, so molecular mass of water molecule will be equal to 1 multiplied by 2 plus 6 16 into 1, that is 2 plus 16 will be 18. So student, molecular mass of water molecule is 18. Alright, so I hope you all have understood this. Now let's move further. Alright, now after molecular mass, let's understand what is mole. So when elements and compound take part in chemical reaction, it is their atoms and molecule that react with each other, and therefore it is a necessary to know the numbers of their atoms and molecules. Now here chemical reaction. So what is chemical reaction? When reactants or some compounds are reacting together to form one product, like carbon and oxygen react together to form carbon dioxide. Okay, so it is necessary to know about the numbers of their atoms and molecules, all right. And however, while carrying out a chemical reaction, it is convenient to measure out quantities that can be handled instead of counting the numbers of atoms or molecules. That means we can easily count their quantities of how many reactants are taking part in the chemical reaction, but to counting the numbers of atoms and molecules, it is difficult. Something difficult. So the concept of mole is useful for this purpose. That means for counting the number of atom and molecule that are taking part in the chemical reaction, the mole concept has been discovered. All right, now let's understand what is exactly a mole. So mole is that quantity of a substance whose mass in gram is equal in magnitude to the molecular mass of that substance in Dalton, and value of Dalton, you know, that is 1.66. okay, now student, by this we can understand that a mole helps to make large number of atoms and molecules more manageable. Okay, and you can understand this example by taking an example of bags of potatoes. Okay, it can be time taken to count a storeroom of potatoes, but if the potatoes are in bags and every bag contains 100 numbers of potato, it can make it making the much easier to count the potatoes instead of counting the storeroom. So mole is just like that only. All right, and the SI unit of mole is mol, that is mol. Okay, and thus the molecular mass of oxygen is 32 U, that is Dalton, and therefore 32 gram of oxygen is 1 mole of oxygen, and the molecular mass of water is 18 Dalton, that is U, and therefore 18 gram of water make 1 mole of water. That means you can think 18 gram is such a big quantity, but 1 mole is okay, to represent 18 gram, we are using here 1 mole of water only. Okay, now here the formula is given to calculate the mole. Okay, so the number of mole of substance may be any number. Okay, so here it is represented by N. So number of moles of a substance is equals to mass of a substance in gram upon molecular mass of a substance. All right, so mass of a substance upon molecular mass of a substance. By using these two, we can calculate easily the number of moles of any kind of substance. All right, our next topic is Avogadro's number, that is Na, and the value of Na is equal to 6.023 × 10⁻²³. All right, now let's understand what is it. Alright, so the number of molecules in 1 mole of any substance is constant. That is, the number of molecule in 1 mole, like we have seen in for water molecule, 1 mole is equals to 18 gram of water. Okay, so this value will be constant. This will never change. Okay, so the Italian scientist Avogadro did fundamental work in this constant, and therefore this number is called as a Avogadro's number. That means Avogadro's number has been given by the scientist Avogadro. Okay, and it is denoted by the symbol Na, and Avogadro's number Na is equal to, that means value of this Na is equal to 6.022 × 10⁻²³. A mole of any substance stand for 6.022 × 10⁻²³ molecules. Alright, now here a mole of any substance, okay, a mole of any substance stand for this much molecule, and just as a dozen has 12 item, that means in one dozen has 12 item, and a century has 100, okay, 100 number, and a gross has 144 numbers, and a mole means, that means 1 mole means 6.022 × 10⁻²³. okay, and for example, here we are taking example, a mole of water, that means 18 gram of water contains 6.022 × 10⁻²³ molecules of water. That means 18 gram will be equal to this 6.022 × 10⁻²³, and this quantity is fixed, this is constant. All right, now let's take one example that how the mole is calculating. Okay, so how many molecules are there in 66 gram of carbon dioxide? Okay, so let us understand this. First method is by using the molecular mass of carbon dioxide. So the molecular mass of carbon dioxide is 44. Just now we have seen in previous slide the formula for calculating the mole. So for that we requiring the molecular mass. Okay, so molecular mass is 44, and formula for to calculate the mole is number of moles in the carbon dioxide. It is N is equals to mass of carbon dioxide in grams. Okay. Upon molecular mass of carbon dioxide. So mass of carbon dioxide is 66 upon molecular mass, just now we have seen that is 44. Okay, now here after dividing 66 upon 44 we will get N is equals to 1.5 mol. Okay, 1.5 mol, and therefore 1 mole of carbon dioxide contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 molecule. That means 1 mole is equal to this quantity is fixed, that is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. So what we will do, we will do the cross multiplication. That means 1.5 mole carbon dioxide contain 1.5 into Avogadro's number, that is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 molecule, and this will be equal to, that means 1.5 into Avogadro's number will be equal to 9.033 into 10 raised to 23 molecules. That means the molecules are that means in 66 gram of carbon dioxide this much, that is 9.033 into 10 raised to 23 molecules are present. So I hope student your today's topic, all the three concept you have understood very well, and next and the last part of this lesson we will continue in our next session. Thank you all.